淘宝买的，拼多多买的，苹果13 Pro 买的。
可以买个那也可以买这类的鞋子的。
你看，也不知道是真是假。
100-200多。
假的吧，这个。
In recent years, Chinese manufacturing has been trying to shift to high-end production. Although China has a massive electronics market, its manufacturing sector is still as far apart from world leaders as pineapples are to apples. In addition to chip shortages, China has begun to see a much more significant shortage of passive components, which have also experienced a price hike. Among the common passive components, RCL components including resistors, capacitors, and inductors are the core passive parts, accounting for more than 90% of the total. Since the end of 2020, the biggest price increases in China have been for multi-layer ceramic capacitors, or MLCCs. MLCCs in the electronics industry is like rice in the food industry, used in products such as cell phones, computers, home appliances, and automobiles. According to data released by the China Electronic Components Industry Association, the global market size in 2019 for capacitors is the largest at $22 billion. The inductors market size is about $6.9 billion. Resistors have about $3.7 billion in market share. Mainland China accounts for 43% of the total, which is about $11.9 billion. The data shows that based on the latest electric vehicle specs, the number of MLCCs used in each vehicle is about 13,000. The next generation of self-driving cars is expected to have 15,000 MLCCs. The cost of electronic components in new energy vehicles is much higher than that of traditional cars. On the other hand, a cell phone uses about 1,000 capacitors and several hundred resistors, accounting for the greater half of a phone's electronic components. China consumes trillions of capacitors and resistors each year. Although China has the world's largest market for basic electronic components and it can produce various types of capacitors and resistors, these products can only occupy the middle and low end of the industry chain. And the market is full of counterfeit and poor quality goods.
看到很多人买这个神奇的东西装在自己的车上。
I see many people buy this amazing thing to install on their electric bikes. The description says it's very powerful, exceptionally powerful. It allows the bike to start strong. It can also protect the battery and extend its life. So what makes it so powerful? Today, we will disassemble it to see what's inside, what makes it so great. Look carefully, see what's inside. Anyone with a little knowledge of electronics should be familiar with this. The most amazing thing is, it's not connected here. Wires aren't even connected. I am impressed by the smarts of our Chinese. They are incredible. Chinese media admit that in the global market of electronic components and its high-end market, Japanese companies are the first rank with a solid edge. The United States, South Korea, and Taiwan fall in the second rank overall. Mainland Chinese companies stand in the third rank, providing mainly low and mid-range products. Japan captures more than half of the global share with leading giants like Murata and TDK. The gap between mainland Chinese manufacturers and the Japanese giants lies first in raw materials. For example, the primary raw material for MLCC is barium titanate. Other than that, there can still be thousands of other raw materials involved, many mixed versions of raw materials, and also mixed organic solvents. The Japanese giants have deep technical know-how about what materials to use and how to mix them. Chinese manufacturers still have to rely on imports when it comes to top materials. Another example is the production of high-end capacitors and resistors. The most critical criterion is that the quality should be as consistent as possible within one batch. That is, millions of pieces can be produced in one batch. If the quality is inconsistent or substandard, it will cause a series of impacts on the industry chain, including the procurer. Thus, quality consistency is considered the most vital aspect of high-end capacitors and resistors. For example, a substandard capacitor could slow down the charging of a cell phone. To avoid such problems, major brands of cell phones usually choose to purchase capacitors and resistors from leading manufacturers. An MLCC is only the size of a grain of rice. It's a ceramic block with electrodes inside, stacked with hundreds or even thousands of layers of ceramics and metals to store electric charges. The more and thinner the layers of dielectric, the larger the capacitance value. Every step of the production has to be precise so that the production can meet the standards fully. Often, customers only allow one failure out of a million MLCCs as a general requirement. With the production process being complex but the error tolerance being only one in a million, it is the touchstone to distinguish the high-end manufacturers from the middle and low-end manufacturers. It's Murata's stronghold. Currently, Murata's MLCC products can achieve 1,000 layers, while Chinese products can only achieve about 300 layers. Murata's product has better details, high consistency, and isn't prone to mechanical damage. When interviewed by Nikkei News, Murata's president said, "In the current situation, for parts manufacturers in mainland China and Taiwan to catch up with Murata's technology, it's estimated to take 3 or 4 years. The reporter followed up and asked, "How do Japanese companies maintain their dominant position?" He replied, "Japanese electronic parts manufacturers haven't compressed their investment in research and development. Murata is also planning 10 years from now. Chinese companies are good at catching up with what's already on the market, but it's not easy to do so in electronic components." That is, while China has yet to solve the problem of batch consistency, Japan is already laying out what the technology will be 10 years from now. In the first half of 2021, the prices of these products have increased by nearly 30% in China. By the second half of 2021, some of the world's largest manufacturers of passive components have also followed suit with price increases. On August 9th, Vishay, the leading resistor manufacturer in the US, announced a 10 to 20% price increase. As a result, the Chinese media wrote, in envy, "Japan's Murata, TDK, US Vishay, South Korea's Samsung Electromechanics, and a host of manufacturers have earned loads of money. The electronics companies in China seem to have no choice but to pay the high prices. If China's semiconductor industry wishes to achieve independence, it needs to make up for the gap in passive components, in addition to the chip manufacturing industry. It looks like China's semiconductor industry still has many difficulties ahead before reaching the world top. Huawei, which is the top 100 electronic information company in China, is a clear example of this. The US and many of its allies have excluded Huawei equipment from the respective lists of suppliers for 5G network construction, fearing national security risks due to suspicions about Huawei's ties to the Chinese military. Huawei has also been placed on the US Department of Commerce's sanction list, which prohibits US companies from selling to Huawei without permission. On October 29th, Huawei announced its operating results for the first 3 quarters of 2021. Its sales revenue has fallen about 32% year-on-year. The Associated Press reported that Huawei was having trouble retaining market share because it was denied access to American processor chips and other technology due to sanctions. On October 28th, Reuters, citing two unnamed sources, reported that Huawei had hired heavyweight Democratic lobbyist Tony Podesta to lobby the Biden administration and had paid him $1 million in lobbying fees. A third quarter lobbying report filed by Podesta this month disclosed that Huawei paid him $500,000 in lobbying fees. The lawyers added that paying lobbyists up front, as Huawei did, is rare when lobbying efforts haven't started yet. Reuters reported in late August that the Biden administration had approved the sale of hundreds of millions of dollars worth of automotive chips to Huawei. Huawei has asked those suppliers to reapply to raise their sales amount to $1 billion or $2 billion US dollars. Such licenses, once approved, are typically valid for 4 years at present. According to the US government records, Huawei has spent about $3.42 million US dollars so far in 2021 on internal and external lobbying efforts. In addition, Huawei announced in November 2020 that it was selling its low-cost branded smartphone unit, Honor, to a syndicate of more than 30 resellers and distributors. On October 14, 2021, a group of Republican U.S. senators led by Senator Marco Rubio called on the Biden administration to blacklist the company, Honor. There was also bad news from China's home appliance industry. The U.S. Department of Justice released a statement on its website stating that Chinese Gree Electric reached a deferred prosecution agreement with the U.S. Department of Justice. Under the terms of the agreement, Gree Zhuhai and Gree Hong Kong agreed to accept fines totaling approximately $91 million and agreed to pay compensation to the victims of fires and related fires caused by the company's defective dehumidifiers. According to a report on dehumidifier accidents by the Taiwan Refrigeration and Air Conditioning Industry Association, statistics on dehumidifier accidents between 2008 and 2016 primarily concentrated on two causes: voltage-dividing capacitors and relays, with voltage-dividing capacitors being the most common cause. Gree Electric released an explanation concerning Gree Electric's lawsuit in the U.S. on China's social media platform WeChat, saying that the problems involved happened 8 years ago and that no similar problems have happened since 2013. However, Chinese media reported that Gree products have also experienced repeated incidents of spontaneous combustion in its products sold in China during 2020 and 2021. Gree Electric claims to be the largest air conditioning company in China and the world, with the slogan, "Let the world fall in love with Made in China." Just like the difference between pineapple and apple, if the red DNA doesn't change, the day of making the world fall in love with Made in China may never come.
Ah, 这不对上，就差一点，方向盘掉了。我，这不玩命吗？这是。